يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الإخوة المسلمون، brothers and sisters in Islam, with a year ending and another one beginning, صاحب القلب السليم، صاحب الضمير الحي، those who have sound hearts, a living consciousness, must stop and reflect. You must undergo an honest self-criticism pertaining to your journey back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is it? If you are to die today, would you like to die in the condition you are in right now? واحذر and be aware. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من مات على شيء بعث عليه. Whoever dies doing some act, he will be resurrected in the day of judgment, in the land of gathering, doing it. Because with a year passing by from your lives, brothers and sisters in Islam, you're 1 year closer to your destination. أول منازل الآخرة, the grave, the first stop in the hereafter. Someone who is much better than me and you, certainly, used to cry to the extent that his beard would become wet when he stand on the top of a grave. And then when he was asked, we talk to you about Jannah and about hell, you do not cry as much as you do when you stand on the top of a grave. He said, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, I heard the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, إن القبر هو أول منازل الآخرة. The grave is the first stop of the hereafter. الحديث أخرجه الترمذي من حديث هانئ مولى عثمان رضي الله عنه, the one who used to cry. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a very known predecessor, his name is Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad رحمه الله. One day he met a man and he asked him, how old are you? He said, 60 years. He said to him, that means you have been traveling for 60 years back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you're about to reach your destination. The man responded by saying, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. This is the fate of each one of us. Then Al-Fudayl asked him, do you know what that means? He said, no. Explain to me. He said, that means you're a slave to Allah. And very soon you will stand in front of your Lord. And he will ask you about every single thing you did. Every single word you said. فما أنت قائل What will you say فبكى He cried وقال ما العمل يا أبا علي What should I do يا أبا علي قال He said it's easy أحسن فيما بقي يغفر الله لك ما مضى Stick to the straight path In the rest of the journey, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive the past, the sins in which you committed. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you cannot do this. You cannot do that self-examination when you are in a loud place with music and mixing. And sometimes weed, and sometimes drugs. Celebrating what? Losing a year of your capital? Son of Adam, your only hours. When 1 hour passes by, you lost your capital. You lost an hour from your asset. Brothers and sisters in Islam, longing to that upcoming year. I'm celebrating the new year. What kind of a year will you have? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us that having a long life minus good deeds is the worst. Wal hadith fi sunan hadith Abdullah ibn Bisr radiyallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, Ya Rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, من شر الناس? Who is the worst of mankind? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, من طال عمره وساء عمله. The one who gets to live long life without doing good things in it. ومن خير الناس يا رسول الله? Who is the best of mankind, O Messenger of Allah? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من طال عمره وحسن عمله. That you live long life. Quite frankly, brothers and sisters in Islam, if 217 is going to be another year when I don't pray my 5 prayers, my 5 salawat, when I'm gonna indulge more in adultery, when I'm gonna smoke more, drink more, when I become rude and mean to my parents more, when I become more evil, I don't want it. If you have a living heart, you shouldn't want that 217. You shouldn't want it. You should actually ask Allah, اللهم اجعل الحياة وهذا دعاء علمنا إياه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم اجعل الحياة زيادة لي في كل خير يا رب make 217 a path of goodness and if I am not to do this واجعل الموت راحة لي من كل شر I want to die يا رب Is that your attitude? Brothers and sisters in Islam, Umar ibn al-Khattab, رضي الله عنه, والأثر أخرجه الإمام مالك في موطئه. When he performed his final Hajj, Abdullah ibn Abbas was accompanying him. So after he left Mina, قال يا ابن عباس ايتيني بوضوء. يا ابن عباس bring water for me to make وضوء. الوضوء الماء, الوضوء is the وضوء. He made وضوء and he prayed two ركعز ورفع يديه إلى السماء. And he raised his hand up and he said, اللهم طال عمري وضعفت قوتي واتسعت رعيتي فتوفني إليك غير مفرط. يا رب, I'm getting older. I'm an old man. And with the age, your strength وضعفت قوتي. And meanwhile, my ra'iyya is expanding. Too much responsibility, ya Rab. And we know Umar, قال لو عثرت دابة في العراق لسئل عنها ابن الخطاب يوم القيامة. If an animal in Iraq doesn't have a way to walk on, Umar will be asked. And we know that he would walk around Medina at night. He's not like one of these leaders we have these days where they kill their citizens to stay in office. No. He's an honest leader. So he's saying, Ya Rab, if I am to waste my amana, then it's time to go, Ya Rab. It's time to go. And he made a very interesting dua. وَتَوَفَّنِي شَهِيدًا فِي بَلَدِ نَبِيِّكَ. And I want to die as a shaheed in the city of your messenger. Abdullah ibn Abbas, what is this? How are he going to die as a shaheed in Medina? If you want to die as a shaheed in Medina, you have to go to the outskirts fighting with the army. Some narration 15 days later, some others a month, some others two, he was stabbed by Abu Lu'lu'ah al-Majusi Fayruz while he's leading the Salah. الشاهد يا إخوة, عمر رضي الله عنه did not want to live longer, did not want that long life if it's not going to lead to him carrying on with what he's doing. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm really today asking you to do something abnormal, something weird. It doesn't go with the mainstream. The mainstream that you go out there and you smoke a joint and you get a drink. Happy New Year! Happy New Year! Happy New Year! Oh, 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 oh. That's an indication that the heart is not sound and the consciousness is dead. Brothers and sisters in Islam, اعقل. I'm calling you to do something called محاسبة. Criticizing yourself. وأصلها ثابت في القرآن. قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد. Oh, you believe, have taqwa in Allah, and let every soul look into what you have sent of provision, hasanat, for tomorrow. Like I asked, if you die today, are you ready? واتقوا الله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, محاسبة النفس is an important tool. Even businesses, they do assessment of their performance. They do auditing. That's what you're supposed to do. You scan into your years, into your lives, and assess your journey. And there are some of obstacles, some of the obstacles which come in the way of this. 3, 4, I'll share them with you. Number one, يا أيها الإنسان ما غرك بربك الكريم. O insan, O mankind, what makes you deceived about who Allah is? الإرجاء دب في الأمة. الإرجاء. يا brother, Allah غفور رحيم. Brother, my heart is white. والله يا شيخ, والله يا شيخ, أنا قلبي أبيض. أنا بس ما بصليش خمس مرات في اليوم. My heart is white. I don't pray five times a day. My clean, I have clean. يا الله غفور رحيم. نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم. Tell my slaves, O Muhammad, that I am the forgiving, the merciful. But in the other hand, وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. Allah will punish too. There is a punishment too. There is Jannah and Hell, both. There is Targhib, Tarheeb. You see, at the end of the day, brothers and sisters in Islam, we believe that whatever we do is not going to save us. Whatever you do is not going to save you. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم اعلموا أنه لن يدخل أحدكم الجنة بعملي. None of you will enter Jannah because of your عمل. ولا أنت يا رسول الله ولا أنا. What? إلا أن يتغمدني الله برحمته. Unless Allah bestows His mercy upon me. But for you to receive Allah's mercy, you must strive. But you can sit down and do the haram and abandon the obligations and say, لا لا, هذه أماني. أماني. You know what أماني means? Wishful thinking. ليس بأمانيكم ولا أماني أهل الكتاب من يعمل سوءا يجز به ولا يجد له من دون الله وليا ولا نصيرا. We're living in a community where people say that someone died for my sins. You're good. هذا إرجاء. The second reason or the second عائق, obstacle, brothers and sisters in Islam, to do this is despairing, which really the opposite. A lot of the brothers, a lot of the sisters, they say, you know what, Sheikh, I done too much and I don't think Allah is going to accept me again. Rest assured, this is a gate of shaitan. Iblis, that is the name, derives from a noun called al-balas, which is despair. Because Iblis despaired from Allah's mercy, he's going to make you despair. No. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu says, arja aya fi kitabillah, the verse which gives the most amount of hope in the Quran, this verse. What verse? في سورة الزمر, قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا. Allah will forgive all sins. Brothers and sisters in Islam, don't despair. Actually, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so joyful because of your comeback to Him. If you scan the Quran and the Sunnah and you want to get the story of a man or a woman who was the most joyful, is this man. What is his story? He was traveling from one place to another and he had to go through the desert. And he had all his belongings, his livelihood in the back of a camel. So in the middle of the desert, he needed to get some rest. He went underneath a tree and he took a nap. He did not tie his camel. The camel ran away. Ran away. He went looking for it. In some of the wording out of Imam Muslim, that he did like Hajar in the desert. going back and forth. He didn't find it. He said, let me go and die under that tree I was napping. So he opens his eyes accidentally like this, and he sees the camel standing next to his head. He held the rein of the camel like this, and he looked up and he said, Allahumma anta rabbi wa ana abduk. That's what he meant to say. He swapped the words. He actually said, oh Allah, you are my slave and I am your Lord. But this is what he meant to say. Look, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَخْطَأَ مِنْ شِدَّةِ الْفَرَحِ. He made a mistake because of excessive joy. Imagine this. لَاللَّهِ أَفْرَحُ بِتَوْبَةِ عَبْدِهِ مِنْ هَذَا الرَّجُلِ. Allah is more joyful because of your comeback to him than this man. وَنُثْبِتُ صِفَةُ الْفَرَحِ لِلَّهِ. We affirm the attribute. We believe that Allah is joyful, but in a way that suits His Majesty. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we read in the Sunnah that a prostitute, أعزكم الله, a woman who works as a prostitute, she repented. She did actually a righteous deed. She given a drink to a dog. And because of that good deed, Allah guided her to repent, because I don't want to leave you with the impression that you can do whatever you want to do, and what you have to do, just give drinks to dogs. That's not how it goes. La, because of that deed, Allah guided her to repent. Allah guided her to come back to Him. And she died like this. Brothers and sisters in Islam, don't despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do you need to do if you're really serious about making a change in the next year? But before I narrate that story of this man, because sometimes this story may open the door that killing is easy. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the most awful thing that a person can do with his deen is to kill another person. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يزال المؤمن أو المسلم في فسحة من دينه ما لم يصب دما حراما. Your chances for salvation are high in the hereafter as long as you don't kill another person. Abdullah ibn Umar is the narrator of this hadith. والحديث عند البخاري وإن من ورطات الأمور لمن أوقع نفسه فيها سفك الدم بغير حل. One of the greatest masses that you can find yourself in, that you kill somebody unjustly. وسئل عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما هل للقاتل توبة. The one who kills, he has a chance. He looked at the questioner and he said ثكلته أمه. May his mother lose him. يأتي المقتول يوم القيامة. The one who was killed in the day of judgment will come يحمل رأسه على يديه, carrying his head in his right hand. تشخب أوداجه دما. The veins of his necks are pouring blood in the land of gathering. يجر قاتله, dragging his killer. Dragging Assad, dragging all those killers who are killing the Muslim children, the Muslim women. And they will go and stand in front, he will go and فَيَذْهَبُ فَيَقِفُ أَمَامَ رَبِّي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. And he will go and he stand in front of Allah. ثُمَّ يَقُولُ. And he will say, يَا رَبِّ سَلْ هَذَا فِيمَ قَتَلَنِي. Oh Allah, ask him why he killed me. Why did he bomb me? These killers think that they will escape. لا والله. لا والله. When Al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi killed Abdullah ibn al-Zubayr, عير أمه أسماء. أسماء بنت أبي بكر. Abdullah is her son. Al-Hajjaj came to أسماء. يقول لها ألا ترين ما فعلت بابنك. He killed him actually and he put him on a cross in Mecca. Abdullah ibn Zubayr, the son of Zubayr ibn al-Awwam, أول مولود في الإسلام. حنكه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم حنكه. Abdullah ibn Umar, Al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi used to say about him, شر الناس, the worst of people. Abdullah ibn Umar, one day he was passing by him when he was hanging on that cross. He looked at him and he said, والله ألا إني كنت أنهاك عن ذلك ألا إني كنت أنهاك عن ذلك ألا I banned you from doing this. You shouldn't be doing this. You caused the fitna يعني. You should have just stayed away from these rulers. لقد علمتك صواما قواما وصولا للرحم. I only knew someone who fast every day, pray tahajjud every night, uphold his kinshita. لا أمة أنت شرها. An ummah, you're the worst of them, لهي خير الأمة. That's the best of the ummah. If Abdullah ibn Zubayr is the worst. الشاهد, الحجاج went to أسماء, said, because الحجاج asked for أسماء to come to his house. He sent his servant, bring أسماء to me. He said, no, I'm not coming to him. So he got very angry and he went to her. Did you see what I have done to your son? She said, yes. رأيتك أفسدت عليه دنياه وأفسد عليك آخرتك. شاف الكلام؟ Yeah, I see. He just messed up his life in this world, but he messed up your hereafter. You wait until you go there. فالقتل. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a man killed 99 souls. And he want to repent. He want to come back to Allah. He went to somebody who doesn't know the deen. Not everybody who wears this. Do I have a chance? No way. Even out of intelligence, out of fiqh, someone killed 99 people. You know, he's asking you, I have a chance for repenting. You said, absolutely. No question about it. Yes, you have a chance. He said, no. You have no chance. يحكون لنا in the East Coast, someone was delivering the khutbah like this, and as if he said something that the people did not like. One of the people did not like it. So he stood up with a gun, and he looked at the khatib and said, come down. Come down. You know what the khatib did? أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. Somebody killed 99 souls. You tell him you have no chance. He killed him. 100 now. Again, he want to repent. He went to the knowledgeable person. Yes, you have a chance, brothers. 217 can make that change in your lives. But this is what you need to do. You need to migrate. You need to migrate. You need to leave off all the friends who got you in trouble in 216. 217 must be a different company, a different environment, the masjid, the imam, the Quran. You know what, brothers and sisters in Islam, he did not delay one of the weapons that shaitan uses. Inshallah, Sheikh, I will. يا أختي الحجاب إن شاء الله لما أتجوز إن شاء الله when I get married I'll wear it إن شاء الله brother الصلاة إن شاء الله شيخ let me have some fun and then I will get married and I'll be he right away traveled almost at the halfway line the two groups the angel of mercy the angels of mercy and the angels of punishment came claiming his soul the angels of mercy They said he belongs to us. He repented. The angels of punishment said he did not do a hasana. So they quarreled. Allah sent an angel to arbitrate. He said, measure the distance between origin and destination. If he has crossed the halfway line, then he goes to the angels of mercy, goes to Jannah. And if he is behind, he goes with the angels of punishment. Brothers and sisters in Islam, they found him that much. An inch behind. But رب غفور رب رحيم Allah commanded the earth, scoot over, move, وأخذ به إلى الجنة. This is what you need to do. Leave the environment. Start a new environment. Engage. This is your New Year resolution. If you have a living heart, if you have a living consciousness, and a sound heart. If you don't have those, then you're going to carry on with what you're doing. We ask Allah to guide all of us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. Thank you.